course, everybody comes to fun in this depression, struggling to get up in the morning, you laugh at yourself, either hear a shower or you don't hear a shower.
Now, does anyone... Depression, I heard comedy, but I have no idea what was in between.
So what you were saying is like, you know, comedians, we talk about depression.
We talk about depression,
hold on, I need to hear him say that.
Comedy, we talk about depression, we talk about dark subjects, but like, do you think comedy is like kind of like an antidote to depression? Like, instead of just being down and being sad, like you find a way to laugh about it. And that's kind of like, is that what you're trying to say?
No, it usually are. It's... To be funny is to be depressed. To see the dark side there of the world, right. Laugh about it, or do you let the world get you doing?
Okay, so that one I got, because I know Dune. Dune means down.
I was in Amsterdam, and I did a joke about the short-lived Twitter-based post-Super Bowl Budweiser boycott. In the joke, I briefly referenced Heineken, and it turned out someone in the crowd worked for Heineken.
They both boycotted that one. I got the jokes. They did not boycott Heineken after that. They tried. That is not true. Heineken had nothing to do with that ad campaign. Where does your information come from? You work at Heineken, and a bunch of American rednecks, because of a Budweiser Super Bowl commercial, I don't even believe you have a job. Because none of that makes sense at all. I know they're dumb, but they're not that, like, there's a certain point where they're just being like, I'm tired, and then they don't. They boycott it because of the Budweiser commercial, or because there was a separate Heineken
because
commercial?
Because
the Open Your World thing.
Yeah. Said,
oh,
this alien.
And that was, but that's a different.
Yeah, it's Heineken.
Right. It's a Heineken commercial aired at a different time. No, that's true. You know what? And at one point, there have been boycotts on a great deal of products throughout the ages. Like, there have been moments throughout history where a bunch of people got together. They're like, we're not going to shop at this particular store, support this particular product. And each one of them has just as little to do with that joke. Okay. What do you do for Heineken, miss?
I do guest experience at the Heineken experience.
You do guest experience at the Heineken experience. You're a tour guide. Okay, good, because I don't want you telling them that story. Because they'll come through and be like, actually, during the Budweiser boycott, we were affected a great deal as well. I'm getting, that was my transition right back to the jokes. Don't you derail this. Bikes are very difficult when more than one person is trying to pedal at once. All right. So the point is, sometimes people on Twitter talk about stuff that they don't know the intimate details about.
What's also great is that we have performed in 11 different cities in 8 different countries in Europe over the past 2 weeks, and not a single person has come up to us and been like,
I like him.
Not a single one. Universally, you're all like, yeah, he's a piece of shit. England elected Theresa May. And they're like,
yeah, but fuck Trump.
Like, she's... Which is amazing to me, by the way, that England did that. Because, like, they were making fun of us. England was making fun of us. And they were just like,
yeah, you guys are so dumb. You elected Trump.
And then they're like, what if we elect the female Trump? Like, that... It's so crazy. Yeah, England, by the way, let me say this as an American. A lot of times when I travel around, it's hard to be an American because people will be upset with us because they'll be like, you guys have so many problems with racism and ignorance. And then I got to England and I was like, we're doing okay. Holy shit. England is so racist, they wanted to leave Europe. That's what happened because all these refugees were coming in and they're like, we need help. And England was like, not from us. And because England was worried, they were worried that like if they allowed too many refugees in, that could like ruin their economy. And so they're like, let's fuck it up before they get here. That's basically what they're like. They can't ruin our economy if we don't have one left.
One fan couldn't wait till the end of the story I was telling to find out where it took place. He meant well, but it still led to this interaction.
What country was it in?
What country was it in?
Yeah.
In where I live, America. Okay. where that was an important part of the joke. I was gonna get there, but everyone else is taking the stairs. You're like, elevator!
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, it's a library. Anyway, so I get pulled over in America.
Later on in the show, I did a joke making fun of British Prime Minister Theresa May, and a British expat was not happy about it.
Yours can read.
Yours can read.
Yeah.
Your Prime Minister.
I don't
want to
say I'm English.
I don't need. Well. Yeah. Oh, sure. Your Prime Minister can. Yeah, your Prime Minister can read. She reads Mein Kampf. She reads.
In Brussels, there's a statue of a little boy peeing, and it is in a very touristy part of town.
Have you seen the mannequin piss?
Have I seen the mannequin piss? I have. That's where we got the waffles. You go to my Instagram. I put on my Instagram story because there's like a stat. There's a statue of not the pissing mannequin. Which, by the way, it's so funny that it's mannequin place, like PLS, and it clearly looks like mannequin piss on the map. Like, that's what it looks like. Like, Andrew was like, holy shit, that says mannequin piss. I'm like, no, it's mannequin place, I think. Right? Isn't it? Like, PLS. It's PIS?
Yeah.
Oh, fuck, really? Welcome to Europe! This is amazing! It's just, that's the first. So, you guys... You guys made a tribute to, like, there was someone who was just like, you know what, the most important thing in Belgium is little boys pissing.
Wait, did you see the girl version?
The girl version?
Yeah.
I don't want to. There's also a dog. Yeah. That is something I'm used to seeing. That is fucking A, Belgium, this is... As I said, this is why you guys keep getting invaded. This is not because like other places are like, well, let's build a statue to war and to our military power, and you guys are like, you seen this boy piss? You seen this kid? It's amazing. And someone's like, whoa, 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 that's sexist. All right, we'll make a girl piss too.
All right, I am 6'4". A lot of centimeters. It's about 195, 196. And someone just laughed at the idea of that. Yeah, because you guys are Norway and you're like fucking shorty. He's like, only 196? Good luck out there. So the point is, I have to pay extra for the exit row because I need the leg room. If I were 8'4", do you think I wouldn't... I know, you guys are like, yeah, that's what people are here. If I were 8'4", you think I wouldn't buy the seat in front of me? You think I would just dangle my leg over the seat? Just kick in the face at the back of my shoe? Like, don't oppress me, I'm big boned. And I'd be right, because tall people have big bones, so that's how bones fucking work. By the way, if someone is giggling that much about, like... how tall I am joke, that is a drunk girl making a dick comparison right now. That's what's happening. Right now she's just like, how many centimeters? Like right now. I was correct. Anyway, so.
After a few more moments like this, during the Q&A, she got even louder. Technically, before the Q&A even started.
You can ask any question you want, as ridiculous as you want, as personal as you want. I'm like, 100% honestly, we'll see where this goes. Now, hold on, quit it, centimeter lady. We'll get there, but holy shit, you were like, I've been holding this back the whole show.
Have you ever had a girl watch your show and you brought her back to your... hotel room?
Have I ever had a girl watch my show and brought her back to my hotel room? Well, not that one. I love that everybody else is applauding. They're like, yeah, don't you dare. Don't you dare. I would be very disappointed in you.
You folks have been just so much fun. I'm afraid.
Don't you walk to the stage. Don't you do it. This is sacred space.
And then, at the end of the show, my opener, Andrew Rivers, asked the perfect question.
Describe your penis in 5 words or less.
Describe my penis in 5 words or less. Not for that lady there.
Have you ever choked on your water during the show?
Have you ever choked on my water during the show? I have not, thankfully. I have not died during the show. That would be amazing. Do people know the Heimlich maneuver here? Or do you like call it something different because it's England and you call something everything? You'd be like, we call it the Wallingford maneuver, actually. Is someone named Wallingford? No, it's still Heimlich. We just renamed him. We just made him more British. No, I never choked on my water during a show. Did you ask that because you were afraid I was going to? Or because I did it very smoothly. Well, thank you. I've been practicing for years. This is how I get the ladies. I'm like, hey, magic trick. See how I didn't die?
It was also fun walking around in China, Japan, looking like this. Because this is different. Like, when I walk around in the States, and like people give me like kind of a funny look, I'm like, okay, they're trying to figure out where they know me from. They've seen a video and they kind of recognize me, but they're not sure. When I walk around in like the UK and someone like kind of gives me a funny look, then I'm like, they're trying to figure out if I'm their cousin. And when I walk around in Japan and China and people give me a funny look, that's them going, what the fuck is that? So it's a little different. I'm in the next Godzilla movie. Who has any other questions?
As an American, do you understand the metric system?
As an American, do I understand the metric system? I mean, I understand it.
Yeah.
I don't, like, know it well. Like, if you were just like, man, that guy's like 180 centimeters, I would be like, okay. Sounds like he's a measurement. I wouldn't know exactly what it was. That's about 5'10", is that right? Yeah, you guys would have to know. You're 180 centimeters. Yeah, it's about 5'10". I appreciate the display. I appreciate that. I actually bring him along to every show.
What do you think of the red light district?
What do I think of the red light district? I love the assumption that I have already been there. I've been in Amsterdam for like 4 hours. One of them I've been on stage. You're like, yeah, but you already got a hooker. Clearly you already got a hooker.
That vest looks lovely. Do you have a lot of vests?
That vest looks lovely. Do you have a lot of vests? By the way, the way you said that sentence sounded like someone teaching someone a foreign language. Do you know what I mean? It was like, that vest looks lovely. Do you have another one? That vest didn't look like, you know, just... Thank you very much. I appreciate that. I do have a large number of vests. It's kind of become my thing, which was great until I got to Europe and found out that this is the fucking bartender's uniform. Not in America! In America, sometimes, but not all the time. And here, it's all the time, especially in England. In England, every server, every bartender, doesn't matter, shithole pub, they could be not wearing a shirt and they'll wear a fucking vest. And it's very frustrating to me because I didn't know that. And I was out after a show in Manchester and it's my first day walking around England, and I'm at this bar, and this guy comes up to me all excited, and I'm like, oh, a fan. He runs up to me, and I was kind of like, hey man, what's up? What can I help you with? And he just goes, oh, I dropped a glass on the floor. I was like, ah, fuck it.
Have you tried haggis yet?
Have I tried haggis yet? I did. This morning I tried haggis. Next question. I don't want to insult the national food. You know, here's the thing though. I tried haggis because it was at like the hotel breakfast and they had haggis and I was like, I've never tried that. I should do that. I'm in Scotland. I should try haggis. And here's the thing. I don't know if haggis is disgusting or the hotel breakfast is disgusting. Because even the pineapple, I was like, ugh. Like, you know what I'm saying? hard to tell. But there is, if you want, you should go on my Snapchat. Because on my Snapchat, Andrew took a video of me trying the haggis. And my favorite part of the video is not the disgusted face I make after I tried it. It's the hopeful face I made before. The video is basically like, oh, well, you just get to watch me descend into nausea. It's so great. But I'm sure it's very tasty elsewhere.
That's not proper haggis.
That's not proper haggis. I apologize. You know what? A hotel really doesn't make sheep intestines like you should.
Proper haggis is deep fried.
Is deep fried. Yeah, anything is fine deep fried. Taste it. So haggis is supposed to be fried? Just that one guy. That's how he did it. So from now on, I'm like, haggis is fried. I'm gonna go to Edinburgh tomorrow, be like, you guys fry your haggis? They're gonna be like, you fucking stupid. What are you talking about? We only eat it with hotel breakfast. I'm like, ah, shit. I should have known. If you wanna say, hey, Steve, I support what you do, here's 20 euro. Least I could do is give you 5.5 hours of entertainment. Or if you got a really slow friend, that could be like 30 hours of entertainment. And
what,
I did say
what
euro.
What can you get for a fiver?
What can you get for a fiver? Do you buy food like that too?
Pretty much.
Just walk into a restaurant and be like, oh, the cheapest thing is 12 euro. What if I give you 2 euro? What can I get? And they'll say, the fuck out. I want to learn a little bit more about you folks and give you a chance to participate. Some of you tried to take that chance earlier. Wait your fucking turn. So now's your turn. Here's the way it works. You just gave me the finger. Yeah, in the States, that's a compliment. I don't know if you know that.
When he interrupted a third time during the Q&A, I was out of patience.
Hey, friends, Sir Travis,
shut the fuck up! You have talked so much. I'm talking to another person. It's a person who's not you. You can tell because you're sitting there and they're sitting there. And that's how you know that they're not you. Because you can see them when you look over. You can't see yourself when you look over. Or if you can, you are high as fuck. Which is still illegal in this country, so...
You gotta come to Copper's tonight.
I have to come to Copper's tonight.
Yes.
You have to learn to not say everything that comes to your head. You guys really were a ton of fun, and which is great, because this is the, like I said, it's the first show I've ever done in Ireland, and so you guys had an important role there, big responsibility, because you are my impression of Ireland. Soon. Only if you don't.
What torture instrument do you identify with?
Welcome to Scandinavia. This is great. Some places have spirit animals, you guys have torture instruments. I don't think I know enough torture instruments to have really found a soulmate.
Be creative.
So what torture instrument do I... I guess probably waterboarding, actually. Probably waterboarding, because I'm not like a violent person, but I'm annoying enough that after a while people are like, fucking fine. It's gonna be in my next poster, Steve Hofstetter, the waterboard of comedy.
Before I get started here, did someone here order a pizza?
Yeah.
You did? You forgot that it has to come to you.
Well,
it's here. And it got here during Camilla's set, and the guy's just been standing there because he didn't want to interrupt the show. Oh, I'm sorry. Are you embarrassed by ordering a pizza to the front row? Did you not think that was going to go well? I don't think you really considered the logistics of what was going to happen once the pizza got here. Because if you were in the back, or you were at least standing in the back until... By the way, get your fucking pizza. The guy's waiting. I'll talk to them about this while you're back there. Because... Like, once you do that, you'd be like, okay, my food's coming soon, I'll stand in the back in case it comes, and that way I won't disturb anybody. And instead, I spent the last 5 minutes talking to the guy about, we'll find the person, it's all right.
Very drunk, very excited. You gotta not say Edinburgh, a British mate, before you get there.
Wait, in spirit of drunk Brits heckling, and then what did you say?
Are you gonna learn to say Edinburgh?
Am I gonna learn to say Edinburgh the British way before I get there? No. I am closer than most Americans. The fact that I'm not calling it Edinburgh is like some guy I went to summer camp with. This is Ed Inberg.
He's Jewish. His last name ends with Berg. But I do try to say places like the right way to a degree. I've played Australia enough that I say Melbourne now instead of Melbourne, which is what Americans say. But there are other, like, there are people I go home and, like, I'll make a reference to it and I'll say Melbourne and they'll just be like, you pretentious fuck. I'm like, no, that's just how they pronounce it. They just like my name's Steve. Imagine if someone's like, hey, nice to meet you, Stive. I'd be like, what? Why would you do that? This is my friend, Stove. Stop it!
Coming back to Denmark for a third time?
Am I coming back to Denmark for a third time? I would like to. I think that, you know, I think that it's really cool to perform. I mean, you guys already are great. You guys are such a great crowd that I'm having, like, so much fun that I'm literally like, I don't want to do the script that I have to do. And I'm like, no, but I'm really enjoying just talking to you guys, which is great. I think it's a really cool place. Your standard of living is higher than ours. Your education is ranked higher. Your economy is ranked better. You have more rights for women. You have more rights for minorities. You have more rights for gay people than we do. And which is amazing because America is always like, we're number one. We're number one. And I'm just like, do you just mean country code? Like,
I'm a French guy living in the UK. There's no way I can be embarrassed.
You have what?
I'm a French guy living in the UK.
You're a French guy in the UK. There's no way you can be embarrassed. No, there's no way you can not be embarrassed. It's just a constant stream. Well, I don't know if you know this, but as a French guy in the UK, you have quite a responsibility. Because the UK already hates the French. Don't fucking make it worse, okay? Because the UK has all these stereotypes about the French, and now they can be like, and they interrupt shows, what the fuck?
Quite rude.
It's, yeah, you fucking were. All right, so.
What brought you to England?
Paris, area.
What?
Paris.
Paris. Brought.
From Paris.
Oh, you're from Paris. Oh, you just came here for the show?
No, sorry, I didn't hear.
Yeah, clearly.
Were you asking where I'm from, where I live in the UK?
No, I'm asking why, why do you no longer live... You were in France,
yes.
And then you were like, no more! And then you came to England, and I'm trying to figure out, like, why. Was it pre-Brexit announcement or post-Brexit announcement?
It was pre.
It was pre, okay.
I actually lived in the US. I enjoyed it, but didn't feel at home. Went back to France, didn't feel at home anymore. I got a job offer here in the UK. I thought, why the hell not? And I loved it.
That's excellent. And you don't sound, like, your accent sounds much more UK than it does France.
I can do the French accent, there is no problem.
I think he's been faking this whole time. That's awesome. That's great, in case they kick you out after Brexit, so. You're just like, I never left, I'm one of you!
It was very useful in the US where you have, it's something we don't have in France and in the UK where like homeless people come to you and kind of like get you, like they talk to you, they come at you, they're standing up, they come and have a chat with you to like ask you money, whereas they're very passive here in Europe. So I would just be like, no English for me, sorry. And they just go like, and go away. So it was very easy.
You're like, oh, it's a huge advantage when mocking the homeless. It's a huge advantage. I could do that too, though. I could just be like, sorry? And I'm like, how hard is that? And I don't know if you know this, but the average American homeless person isn't going to be like, look, I was in Paris for 4 years. That is not an actual accent. That is... You and I are gonna have a chat, okay?
For me, basically, a city is how much I like a city is based on the show. I don't see much of the rest of the city. That's pretty much like I got here, what, like 3 hours ago?
Four hours ago.
Yeah, just check the time. We got here 4 hours ago, came here, set up for the show, doing the show. Like, what are you doing after the show? Sleeping. What are you doing after that? Going to Liverpool. They're like, you don't get to be a tourist? I'm like, I'm here for work. You know, like, and I do want to, like, see stuff. Belfast was fun because there was a cab driver telling us to see all the horrible things. He was like, you know, the Titanic is from here. We're like, that didn't work out. And he was like, you know, Game of Thrones was shot here. I'm like, that didn't work out.
The thing that I liked about that taxi driver was breaking the sights while driving us to the train station.
It's like, dude, you think we're just gonna like cancel the train? I want to see how the Titanic ends.
Also, I love the slogan that Belfast has for the Titanic on all their things. It's like the citywide slogan. It says, "She was fine when she left here." Which is like, yeah, that's how planes and boats always look. Like, they're fine at first. But then maybe they don't have enough life rafts. Like, maybe... okay, that's what happened with it. Okay, so...
you know
what
that'd be another good slogan for? O.J. Simpson. Yeah.
Thanks for watching and sharing this video. And thank you for following me on YouTube, Instagram, TikTok, Facebook, and everything else. If you want to watch videos like this before anyone else, check out patreon.com/Steve Hofstetter and come to a live show. I am touring just about everywhere. You can get tickets and see where all my shows are at stevehofstetter.com. Thanks for watching.